Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today we continue with the topic OCR, and today I will explain you how I did to extract text from different formats, not only images, also other containers which potentially can contain images with text. Let's go, and I will be covering this with a notebook as usual that I later will post into my YouTube channel. So just to give you a context, I think I described it on the video before, but well, I will give you a little bit on context, why I need to do that, and how it's the relevant context of this application. This is essentially a component, part of an scanning application with the scan data into that is located in a data lake, an arbitrary data lake. It doesn't matter the cloud provider, it can be also on-premise, usually on-premise, to be honest. And then on Parrot, this component is leveraging the scanning facilities, the scanning capabilities of the tool, and which essentially extracting the text from images. Then it's part of a pipeline, which essentially we take files from the data lake, and then we extract the content, we extract the text, and we analyze this text with different purposes. No, one of these is detecting PII, GDPR entities, or there is detecting offensive language, or there is detecting content not appropriate for a conventional company, for a company policy, etc., etc. So, in this case, the OCR is part of the scanning, text scanning, which is detecting PII and GDPR entities. And then on, well, not only, as obviously you know, not only you may find information that is subject to this protection in document like Word, TXT, or something like that, you also can, this information can be contained in images. Images that come from either from a screenshot or a scanned document, or embedded images that you may place into a Word, a PowerPoint, etc. So we consider, we make a research on the data that we had available, and we see that this data is minimum, but essentially most of the data is contained in scanned PDFs, but well, there is other possibilities, and then we need to cover practically 90.9% of the files that may contain images, and then only, well, we just simply process the file, and it doesn't contain data, doesn't contain text. Well, we move to the next file. And then first of all, we treat all the documents as images. Obviously, OCR is a technology that work with images, and from then extract the text. And those containers like PDFs or Word or PPTs or ODF or other HTML, for example, as well as RTF, which potentially had images, we extracted to images. If the document is multi-page, had multiple images containing text, we extract it to individual images and we process it one by one. At the end, there is a common process for an image, and all those images had the same essentially processing. We send the image to Lectonica, we get the resolution. If the resolution is not good enough, we reject the document and send a message to the user. If not, we process it, and then process it regardless the format. It can be JPG, PNG, GIF, or BMP, and again, all the all the images follow the same path, the same process, and then we extract the text from all of them. So these images to me comes in objects. We is in batches, batches of objects or dictionaries, JSON files in this case, and in these batches come from another tool, another technology that is Elastic, and these batches of the JSON files contains one of the fields the binary representation of the file encoded in Base64. Base64 is not the best how to say encoding, but is for now is the way that we are using to transfer information using conventional HTTP requests in between components. We are thinking how to improve this because Base64 format is transform the binary object into a string, and then it's essentially very very big and it's incrementing a lot the bandwidth necessary to transfer these images over the network, and then this slows down a little bit the application at the whole processing of these files. So we are thinking in ways to how to improve this, but well, we can cover this in another video. Well, we essentially are thinking to use a messaging system like even have or Celery or something like that to process messages and then on work in the background and not transferring in definitive the binary format in the request rather than send a pointer to the file in the localize the file in the lake and read it directly from there. But this is an improvement and it's not connected with the OCR itself. It's how to improve the performance and the speed of the application itself. And then on again, we simply extract the content, the binary content from the attribute that is the Base64 version of the file, and then on with another library we just check which format is this binary content. In definitive, we are controlling the type of the content we had, the file content, no? The file type, and depending it is an image or it is a different container, we process slightly different, no? It is an image, we directly go to extract the text because it's simple. Images are considered one by one, and then you just simply take the image and extract the text, send the image to the OCR library and extract the text. Again, we first of all send it to Lectonica to get the dimensions and the quality of the image, the resolution. And if the resolution is not good enough, we reject it, and we do a slightly different process for Git because Git is slightly different format, and then we transform it to RGBA before to send it for scanning, no? for extracting the text, but the rest of the images, the rest of the formats are treated on the same way, no? In this case, for now, we are just treating GPG, PNG, JPEG, which is the same as GPG, TIFF, JIP, and BMP. And then for containers like TOC or ODT, we use specific libraries, which essentially all of them do exactly the same. Take the image, extract the document. Again, it's coming in Base64 as well, regardless if it is a doc, ODT, PPT, whatever. And then taking the document, we extract individual images to a temporary location, and once they are once they are extracted from the container, doc, ODT, RTF, we process it as images, so they come to the common logic and they are extracted like a conventional GPG. All these specific process for each individual document type transfer the images into GPG, and then on again all of them go to the common image processing, and they are transformed, they are extracted from this. When we had multiple images in a document, we just concatenate the individual pages into a final document, and in case that there is a need to encode or to encrypt the content, because obviously the information finally later is deposited in a data lake. Well, you are extracting the text, and this text can contain, in some cases, like it's the project for what that was designed, contains PII entities or GDPI protected information, and then well, we place it encrypted on the data lake, and then on the next application we consume it at their convenience, and they will decrypt the text extraction that we get from these documents. So from doc and docx we just simply use a library, doc to txt. The library is not designed for working with images, it's essentially designed to extract from a doc or docx to txt, but you can use it to essentially to extract the embedded images to a temporary file. No? In the processing, you can specify in the method process, you can specify obviously the document, and the images had to be deposited in the location that you specified on the method. It's pretty simple to use, and then again, once they are transformed into images, let me check show you the document. This one is just simply, it's a use case. Well, we just simply insert some images in the file, and then on what is gonna do the library is take localize this image on the container and extract it individually. You see what this procedure does is essentially, I have it here in another dictionary, extract three files with this the individual images, and then once they are in JPEG format, they are extracted individually one by one. The only difference is is if they come from a container like a doc or a PPT, we concatenate the content of the individual images in a single TXT, and then only process it for the next step on the pipeline. For ODT, ODT is another type of container at the end, and then it has a structure that this can be opened directly with zip files. Zip files, as you surely know, is a tool to compress and compress files, and then on the structure, ODT structure can be simply open it with zip file, and in a folder. So the tree that is how ODT organize the different component text, tables, pictures, whatever is inside the ODT. You can take a look here how is working ODT. But well, it can be analyzed and understood by sys file, and basically the images, you can localize it in the tree of the sys file into a folder that with name picture, and they have a temporary ID. Which essentially you can extract the same that we do with the documents to a temporary folder, and once they are extracted in JPG or another format, you just simply process it with the common logic to extract text from pictures. Same that with docs, we later put all the content in a single file, but well, here is just an example how you can do that. No, library is coming with Python, you don't need to install an additional library, so this is pretty simple to do. ODT, is you know, you don't know, is OpenOffice files, and we didn't find a lot, but well, some of them, some companies use this. This tool as usually is free, and well, people don't need to pay a license for that. RTF and HTML, they are common because, well, for RTF, which is a very old file type, very old type, not many files to be honest, in we found, but some of them, some people still writing more than writing, keeping files, all files in RTF with the inserted images. And to manage to work with that, we simply use a tool, it's a utility that can in Unix for a long time, is a GNU project. This tool is a command line tool, use it on the path to extract or to convert RTF to HTML, and then this is essentially what we do. It's just taking the file and convert it via command line using OS system from RTF to HTML. And once we had the document in HTML, we treat it with Beautiful Soap and Pillow. Once we is extracted and this apply as well to HTML pages, we open the page with a Beautiful Soap, and then we find all the images in the container. Once we had all these images in a list, we just open it with Pillow, and with Pillow we save it to the serialize it to a temporary file and treat it like the rest of the images with the common logic, no? For processing, for extracting text from images. PPT and PPTX, we use another library, which is Python PPTX, which is a Python library which allows you to edit and work with presentations with PPTs, Microsoft PPT, PowerPoint, sorry, and essentially the same that Doc and ODT. No, we just find the image into the container, we extract it, the individual images, and we serialize it to a temporary file, and then on, as you see here, this is an example. You just take a PPT. I think I have also, I can show you the example. Is a PPT which contains, yeah, essentially the same that the other examples. Just we paste the images into the PPT, and then we handle it individually, one by one. Again, pretty simple, and the logic is similar to the previous examples. Here I can show you as well, in this case, from HTML, how it works. Again, is once we extract it from with Beautiful Soap, we create these arrays in these are NumPy arrays, and then we just simply open the file directly from the lake with the, so we serialize the array with the image with Pillow, and then we open it again back with Pillow. Not necessarily, because we can cannot do this with the IO, with the IO library, but yeah, you can see this is just an example to you see that how we do, no? The RTF is containing the same that the other examples, and we just extract it and then on into the temporary file, and then we just open it and process it like individual images and do and follow the same approach that the other files. And what more, just to also to give you some insight how this is done, to test the final endpoint, we are using, as I think also we commented, where is this? It doesn't want to work. Okay, probably. Okay, today doesn't want to work. Let me open it again. So, well, this application at the end is in an endpoint. We have it containerized in a Docker container. Everything is listening. All this application is listening in an endpoint, which with this developed with Fast API, and then on. We have an entry point. We receive again, as I said before, a batch from Elastic. It's coming from a front-end application. This front-end application schedule a job for to scan a folder or a folder in the data lake, and then we receive the files once they are ready from the lake in base64 in batches of 10 files, and then on these files. Get our endpoint, and to test how the process is working, we receive we use well, you probably know this tool as well to test APIs, Postman, but well, also not related, but you can see essentially what exactly we receive in the what receive the endpoint, receive a list of the JSON files or dictionaries, and then again in the content, in these attributes, we receive the base64 content. This is the binary representation in base64, and yeah, and the case that you need some other metadata to later on localize the file, the correct file into the lake, and then, well, here this attributes just to encrypt or not encrypt the extracted text in the response that we return to the lake. You can send this to the endpoint, and as you can see here, well, you just get the extraction of the text contained on the image, no? And as it is quite easy, so or at least, bueno, it's quite easy to implement an end-to-end pipeline with the Tesseract. The performance is quite well, especially when you combine this with the tools like Fast API, which allow you to do multi-processing and work with files on parallel and in batches. So it's combining both tools and also dockerizing the application, you are gonna get a very good output. And as I mentioned on the video before, you don't need to move this data to a GPU for processing, because well, the nature of the how this process works make that this option being not worth it, and even not advisable because of the complexity of moving data and working with a GPU in a Docker container. So my advice is, well, try to find a solution like this. It's not it you can explore, as I mentioned on the video before, Paddle OCR, which allows you to work with a GPU. Even again, there is some wrappers that works with with Tesseract, but yeah, this not for what I saw it it's also a job that some people did some years ago, and looks like that they didn't update the software because nobody or didn't continue with that process. So this is how I did it. I hope that will be useful for you in your case. If not, well, at least you can take some tips from how I did it, and I hope that it help you in your project. And well, that's all. I hope that you like it, and if you like it, as usual, give me a like, and if you like the content I'm doing, subscribe to the channel. I will be publishing regularly this content in this type of the ML projects I was involved on the past. I pretend also I plan to do some comparison, as I promised, for the other tools that are available on clouds, like Azure Computer Vision or OCR Space or the similar alternatives that we have in Google Cloud or Amazon. And then that's all. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon.